Hey guys, welcome to Ask the GM.
Here we are again.
And this time we have a lot more questions this time. Thank you for all of you that had submitted questions.
Dedicated fans, love you, thank you.
Well, I'm just glad that we didn't get like... Imagine if everyone who subscribed sent questions. That would be like way too much. So yeah, thank you guys for actually getting us a lot of questions instead of one. Or a few, or just one by one person. Anyway, so I'm just gonna get this started. The first question is from Bryant, and I don't care. Like you guys said, you guys asked if we're gonna look ratchet this time. I don't, but I didn't really do anything to my hair at all. I was just like, whatever, and I didn't know what to wear, so I just threw on this shirt. And I hope you guys like my background. Yeah, it's my background. It's all Pokemon. Okay, anyway, so the first question is from Brian, and he asks, who's your favorite woman on Women's Revolution? Ugh, why do you have to do this question first? Okay, honestly, I have favorites. I don't have, like, one particular favorite, but if you're asking for one particular favorite, honestly, I don't know why. But I honestly think my favorite is Gigi. Like, I know that there's, like, issues with this drama. I see the drama with Jin and Gigi. I don't remember. I missed a lot, so I don't remember. Wasn't it, like, them two were the last two? And Gigi didn't win, but Jin did. I forgot. But congratulations to Jin for being champion. Actually, she's really good. Brie, you really made her really good, and her attire and her movesets and everything. But I don't know why. Something about Gigi makes her my favorite. But my other favorite, I think it's Riley. I think that's her name is Riley. She has like short hair with the black and red. I can't remember. I forget things. But if I had to choose like second favorites and all the other favorites, it would be like, I don't know why. I'm like favorites to the people that people probably would not expect to be super good or super big, because I look at them like, oh, I can do things with them, you know what I mean? So I don't know, I think that's who my favorite would be.
Good mornings, good afternoons, good evenings to everybody around the world. It is time for Ask GM episode 2. Well, all right, let's get these questions started. And there are going to be some people, links I put down below. Shout out to Damien. His show called Women's Evolution. And he's doing a show where y'all can create your own character. Female character. And, you know, put him on his show. It's kind of the same as Women's Revolution. But his show is called Women's Evolution. So I'll put his link below. Also, Adam. I'm sorry putting y'all name out there. But it's okay. But Adam, his show is called Fearless Knight. Yeah. And I'll put his link below. His YouTube name is WWE Fan. Then I want y'all to check out Junior Man. He do Raw, SmackDown, and NXT shows. Then we got Royalty. He do Glow Live on Thursday. So yeah, I'm going to put the link down below so y'all can check them out and sign up. So shout out to them. And shout out to TLC. You know, he got his own vlogging channel, so y'all need to check that out too. He's good. Make him go crazy, y'all. But okay, let's get started. The first question is from Bryant. How you doing, Bryant? But he asked, who's your favorite woman on Women's Evolution? I think he mean revolution. No shade to none of y'all characters, cause I like them all. But the first day, when I seen Jennifer Bell, she caught my eye. Cause I said I can see a champion in her, which now she is. So yeah, Jennifer Bell is my fave. One of my faves. So, y'all,
is it hard to book matches on Fearless Evolution? It is. It's pretty hard. Like, sometimes it is. Because sometimes I forget If you're asking about the tournament, I don't know, because Jay does all of that, honestly. But if you're asking about our regular, like, show, it's hard because sometimes I'm like, oh, I forget who's on my roster sometimes. Like, I forget a lot of them or whatever. So sometimes it is hard. But sometimes when he asks me, like, to give him matches, like, I'm the type of person who does it at the last minute, and I don't know why, but it works for me. Like, yesterday or whatever, he asked me for matches for another week and, like, two other weeks, and I just, like, had ideas like that. Sometimes my ideas are too much to do, but I come up with ideas pretty quickly when I'm, like, last minute. So it's hard, but it's not. He also asks, what's your favorite finisher in WWE? Ah, I don't know. If you mean currently, I'm trying to think. My favorite finisher currently, I don't know. There's too many good ones, like the figure eight, the bank statement, Becky's armbar, Paige's finisher. It's really hard. I don't know. I don't know what my favorite finisher would be. So I'll get back to that question because I really don't know. I really don't. I mean, if I had to guess, I'm not editing any of this out, so if I get awkward and not, like, you know how to answer quickly, that's whatever. I don't care. I'm not editing this. Well, maybe I will. But yeah, I don't know. I think my favorite finisher. I'm going to do a category. My favorite finisher for the women's category would probably be Charlotte's. I mean, Charlotte's probably, because I like how she transitions into the figure eight, into a bridge. It's pretty awesome. So I guess Charlotte's finisher, I guess. I don't know. It's an answer. What is your favorite year in wrestling and why? My favorite year, I like it now, but my favorite year was when, of course, when, I wasn't, like, I didn't grow up all around that year, but it had to be, like, around the year that Mickey James and everyone was there, and then leading up to when AJ showed up. Like, that's probably my favorite year. And why? Because I feel like it was more exciting back then. And I mean, I know it's not the same as it is now, because now they focus on just, like, you know, they focus on just women doing matches same as men. Like, they're not doing fun stuff like they used to do. Like, you know how they used to do, like, fun stuff like Santa's Little Helpers and stuff? I can't picture Charlotte or Nia Jax doing Santa's Little Helpers and stuff like that now. Now, this is serious. I like that it's serious. I really do. But I do kind of miss the fun stuff sometimes, you know? Like, Santa's Little Helpers or, like, the fun stuff they would do, like, I don't know, like, food fight stuff and stuff like that. I don't like the bra and panty stuff. But it was funny, but, like, I don't. But I do kind of miss the fun things they used to do. Like, Extreme Expose. I forgot how to fucking say that. You know, when, like, Layla and Kelly were dancing. That was cool. I never seen it because I didn't grow up around it back then. But I looked it up and it was funny. It was fun and they could dance. I mean, Layla danced the best. But, you know, so it's really a tough decision to answer that question. But I think it would probably be around back then, you know, with Mickey and all of them, because it was more exciting. Like, they were serious on wrestling, but they also did fun stuff. So I kind of like both. I don't know.
Let's go to the next. Corey. Or Cora. But, for all the people that works for me, Cora is the person that made, Sarah Paul, so now y'all can start asking me, who made Sarah Paul? Who did this and who did that? Now y'all know. So what's up, Cora? Or should I say random kid? He asks, is it hard to book Fearless Revolution? No. It's not hard and it's not easy because, you know, I have to go back and look at my previously videos and videos from the past to make sure, you know, I'm not doing the same storyline. So I try to think of different storylines, and, you know, it's not hard, it's not easy, it's medium, like, so yeah. It's finna rain over here, so, But anyway, the next question he asked was, what's your favorite finishing move? I don't have to say the Widow's Peak, because it's just vicious, and, you know, the Widow's Peak, it's just awesome. I would say Trish Stratus fashion as well. And probably Mickie James DDT, because, I don't know, you know, it's of course it's like a regular move along with Trish Stratus Bulldog, which is a normal move, but, you know, she used something to, you know, spice it up. But I think Mickie James finisher, she spiced it up too when she do the scream with it, you know, to make it sound more like it's going to be more, you know, powerful or whatever. But I have to say Victoria Kai altogether, it just looked vicious. Like, break that bitch neck. But okay, the next question he asked was, what's your favorite year in wrestling? I don't have to say 2006, because back then everything was like more real than it is today. And of course, it's the time of Mickie James, Trish Stratus, Ashley, Victoria, Tori Wilson, and Candice Michelle. And back then, I ain't knew nothing about no SmackDown Divas at the time. I ain't knew nothing. Only thing I was focused on Raw, and I only watched it Raw. Only time I figure out about SmackDown Women's is when I think Eddie Guerrero had passed away, and they did a Eddie Guerrero tribute battle royal for the Divas, and people from SmackDown came over, and that's when Melina came in and won that battle royal. I remember that then. I said, oh, I kind of like Melina, but I said she ain't going to win the Women's Championship, which she didn't. So, yeah, I say 2016. And, I mean, not 2016, but 2006. But I like 2003, too, because I think that was time Lita and Trish was feuding with the Kang and Snitsky thing when Lita was pregnant with Kang's baby. So I liked that, too. But that's what got me hooked to wrestling, 2003. But I like 2006 better. So, yeah, that was his questions.
Okay, Junior Man asked, that was my air freshener thing, if you can make any wrestler or jobber, past or present, who would it be? Throw shade. honestly, if I had the shoes, any who should job. The Bellas. Because, not just because I don't particularly like them anymore, but because they have never, I don't think they've ever jobbed, honestly, in their whole career, I don't think, because they've lost. Like, I'm not saying they haven't lost any matches and whatever, but they've always won stuff, like, all the time. And whenever they come back, they get the most, like, hype. Like, they always get stuff when they come back. Like, they're big shit, you know. When they came back the last time, they got Total Divas automatically, and I was just like, so yeah, the Bells are always doing something, so I probably would job them. It'd be weird to see them get dropped, but probably would job them. Like, seriously, they always do something. Like, who, the person who's always jobbed, who shouldn't be jobbed, is Natalia. Like, she puts on great matches, and she gets dropped. That's why I'm glad she beat Nikki. I'm glad Maryse came out there. And I'm so excited for this rivalry. And I really hope they make Miz and Maryse win. But most likely they're going to make, you know, Nikki win. But hopefully this means this is Maryse's debut to start wrestling again. Like, I hope after this rivalry she's like, you know what? I want the championship. Like, I hope that happens or something. I don't know. Who knows? So, yeah, I probably would job the Bellas. But, you said any wrestler as well, so superstar-wise, Superstar. I'd probably drop Roman Reigns. Alright, so, So if WWE offered you a contract to face anyone in present time, who would you face? Oh God. I don't know. Because I would love to face some of my favorite male wrestlers just because they're snacks and I want to be underneath them when they're pinning me, if you know what I mean. Or like, I don't know. But I don't know. Like, I don't know who I would really want to face because look at me. They'll probably like snap me like a twig, but I'd probably enjoy it. So if I had to face anyone when I came back, it would probably be either Dean Ambrose or Dolph Ziggler or Randy Orton. I don't know. Someone like that. I like how they're like, you know, all dominant and stuff. And now that Dolph Ziggler is heel, so yeah, that'd probably be what we go against, honestly. I don't know, like, I can't answer it truly because I don't know if I would truly want to. Like, I don't know. Like, if I got the option, I don't know if I would truly want to because I don't know if it's something I really want to do. Like, I thought about it. Like, I'd be like, oh, that'd be fun, you know, to be a wrestler and train and blah, 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 blah. But I don't know if I'd be super dedicated to it like they are. So, all right, and
now we got Junior Man. How you doing? But his question: if you can make any wrestler a jobber, past or present, who would it be? Okay. I think I have two. One from SmackDown Live, the Kardashian wannabe. Someone we know that's not gonna get married. No time soon. She basically came back from an injury just to get beat up again to get retired after, you know, WrestleMania. Well, some say take a break, but I think it's gonna be over for her for a good while. Along with Brie. I don't think Brie come back in no SummerSlam. She was just saying if she would come back, she would come at SummerSlam. But yeah, Nikki Bella. Even though she kinda been jobbing a little bit. But I'll make her job, you know, back in the Divas Revolution time, because only reason, because I ain't like how WWE didn't give Team Bad the spotlight. I mean, what the heck? Who does that? Who? WWE does. But, yeah, I had Team Bella to jump to Team Bad throughout the whole Divas Revolution. And you know what? I'm trying to think in it. Comment below if this did happen. But do y'all remember when Sasha Banks made the Divas champion at the time, Nikki Bella, tap out? But however, did Sasha Banks get her championship match? I don't think so. I'm thinking they said, no, forget about Sasha Banks and give it to Charlotte. Wish I like Charlotte now, but still. Woo! So yeah, that's why I would make Team Bella's job, because with them, WWE didn't give other people a chance. They only gave PCB and Team Bella the chance. So yeah, that's why I made job. And the other person, y'all, she's a kid. She's like 6 years old. And she's just Bailey. I'm sorry for y'all Huggers fans out there. But Bailey, she just ain't pulling my attention. Know what I'm saying? This is where she belongs. With the Girl Scouts. Okay? She belongs with the Girl Scout because she's a kid. She acts like a kid. Her gimmick is a kid. And I don't know why she women's champion. But I guarantee you at Fastlane this Sunday, Charlotte will take back what's hers. The title is called Women's Championship. Not no kids championship, but women's. So, Charlotte, please take the championship back. Real fast. But yeah, I'll make her job a lot. Bailey, because to me, when I see her on TV, I'm... That's me, because she bores me. She bores me to my soul. Not soul. Soul. But, yeah, I like her job a lot. So, yeah. She ain't finna get the rest of my time. So, we finna start talking about her. The other question Junior Man asked was, if you were offered a WWE contract to face anyone in the present time, who would you face? Okay, I'm gonna do Raw and SmackDown. I would do Raw. I would face KO, Kevin Owens, only because I don't appreciate what he did to Chris Jericho. But at the same time, I'm thinking they pulling a Lay Cool move. You know how, I think 2011 at the Night of Champion, well, before then, Lay Cool pretend like they starting to depart because Michelle had put more of her name in the hat than Layla's. And once Layla found out, she said she gonna see how Michelle feel when she found out she out there alone at the Lumberjack match to unify the Divas and Women's Championship. So, sorry, I was thinking of something, but I'm sorry, y'all. But yeah, I think they pulling that move too. You know, win over Goldberg. But at the same time, Goldberg probably wins so they can have a Brock Lesnar versus Goldberg match for the championship, Universal Championship at WrestleMania. Which I can see that happen big time. Because I'm sure they probably going to change it up and have Chris Jericho versus KO at WrestleMania. You know what I'm saying? See, keep your eyes out. Keep your eyes out. Open. Or out. Whichever one you want. But yeah. That's why I face on Raw. And on SmackDown, it'll have to be either Bray Wyatt, Randy Orton, or AJ Styles. But mainly I want to face AJ Styles because, you know, he's phenomenal. And he's the face that runs the place. So, you know, to beat him and make him feel the glow. Yes, I got me some glow shoes. I don't feel like getting it right now. Because I'll kick him through this phone. I sure would. But, yeah, to beat him, you might as well say, you're the face that runs the place. So, yeah, that'll be the person I face for Raw and SmackDown. And, what's another question? No. Okay, that was that question. We got some more. This one is from Adam, WWE fan. His question was, thoughts on Melina. Okay. My thoughts on Melina. Around 2006 or 7, when I first seen her, I kind of liked her. But at the same time, I didn't like her. She was here. When I was younger, I was all for the face, but now I'm more to the heel side. Heel J, yes. But Melina, I love Melina, to be honest. I like all her matches.
Last questions are from Adam. He asks, thoughts on Melina? Melina. I heard, okay, so I know she's blonde now, and I love it, obviously, and she's like in the indie type wrestling, and I love it. I love that she's branched out into something different, and I think it's honestly better for her, and it shows, like, all her ability. I don't know, it's fun. It's nice to see her doing something differently. But I feel like she's going to come back sometime soon. And I heard that she challenged, like I watched a video, she challenged Mickey James to a match. So, I'm hoping that means she's coming back soon. And Beth has, she's in the Hall of Fame now, and I think Beth might come back as well. I think they're trying to bring back, slowly bring back everybody. That's what I feel like they're doing. Because Kelly's back, but she's not going to be wrestling right away. I think she's going to be doing like what Emma was supposed to be doing. So Kelly's, where the fuck is Emma actually? But anyway, Kelly's back. Melina's probably going to come back. So thoughts on Melina, I say yes! So yeah. And his last question, what do you think will happen to Naomi at WrestleMania 35? She's going to fucking win. She's going to make it glow. She's going to make that whole arena glow after she wins the championship. And when she slides down that WrestleMania ramp, it's going to be so beautiful. So beautiful. Because it's a long ramp, you know, and she deserves it. She deserves it. She definitely deserves it. I'm really sad still about what happened, but I think that was a setup. Because, like, Jay was saying how after their title match, when she, like, won it, that when she did that move, she was limping. But then after she talked to Renee, I think, she, like, walked off like she was fine. So I think, possibly, it was a setup thing. I don't think she might be actually, like, hurt, but I think that they're using it for a storyline, you know what I mean? To make her win it back at WrestleMania, just so it'd be more rememberable. That's what I think they should have done in the first place. They should have made her come for the month of WrestleMania instead of now. But either way, she's going. She's going to win. She's going to make it glow. And I hope that she makes that title glow. I know she didn't when she got it, but she should. And we haven't even seen her championship entrance. And I heard that she defended it. Jay said she defended the championship on, like, live shows. So I think it's a setup storyline, honestly. And now Natty is going for Alexa's title. So I think they're just waiting it out for Naomi, which is cool. If she wins it at WrestleMania, she will. She better. Because I'm going to be mad. So yeah, this is her year, you guys. And I hope she keeps it longer than Charlotte has. So let's, I mean, longer than, who has had the SmackDown one longest? I'm thinking of Raw. I think Alexa, Becky or Alexa? I think Alexa had it longer. I don't know. But I hope that Naomi wins it and keeps it longer. So yeah, that's going to be the end of this video. Thank you guys for asking those questions. I know that I was probably really weird in this video because I'm not really...
I liked all her matches, especially with Mickey James and, yeah, her and Mickey James. And Melina, she just, she good in the ring. She good with the promos. She just good point blank. I love her primal scream. Damn, Adam. I just like Melina, okay? Except that I just like her. I love her. His next question was, what do you think will happen to Naomi at WrestleMania 33? As you see, I'm supporting my girl. So, to be truthfully, I am hoping for the best for her. But what I'm seeing in my head right now, and it's kind of confusing at the same time, but at the same time, thinking two different things. And I'm finna tell you what I'm thinking. One, I'm thinking that injury was like a little set up, you know, to get, I don't know how to say it, to probably get fans riled up by the time WrestleMania come, cause I feel like she either gonna come back before WrestleMania and take back her championship, or she gonna come back at WrestleMania as a surprise guest to whoever's champion. The reason why I said whoever's champion, because y'all watched SmackDown yesterday. Natalya confronted Alexa, saying that she going to take the championship, basically. So, whoever's champion, like Naomi said, whoever's barring her title, they going to feel the freaking glow and snatch you by like Mr. Clean. Can make you look like Mr. Clean. But, yeah, I think it's a fake injury, but at the same time, I kind of think it's real. Cause when she did do her finisher on Lessa at Elimination Chamber, I seen her once she hit Lessa, she grabbed her knee. But at the same time, she was limping while she was celebrating with the championship. But after Renee and Naomi said their speech, she was walking fine. She got the ring fine. So that's why I'm thinking it's kind of, you know, fake. It's a story leading up to WrestleMania. So we're going to see about that. But that's what I think about Naomi. Then we have one more question. I think it was for me personally. From, hold on, it's loading. But yes, comment below. Give us some more questions. We like questions. We love questions. Okay, where is it? Oh, here it is. All right. From Alex. Or Sour. We call you Hugh Sour. But, his question was, I know how much you like Naomi as a wrestler. Yes. Love. Hell yes. I wanted to know, who would you like Naomi to snatch bald? Hold on, just to tell you. Okay. Who I want Naomi to snatch bald? Well, it's several people, but you know what? A twin. Named Nikki Bella. Only because way back then, they kept making Naomi lose to Nikki Bella. Lose and lose. Especially with the championship matches. Which upsetted me badly. Because it was Naomi time to be Divas Champion. Matter of fact, her time to be Divas Champion was way back when AJ Lee was Divas Champion. Because everything was leading up to for AJ Lee versus Naomi at WrestleMania. But no, Asana had to injure Naomi with her eye. So then that's when WWE just changed the whole thing. Saying, matter of fact, y'all, let's just make the whole women's in that match at WrestleMania for the Divas Championship. And they got us too. They got us good because the Naomi fans will understand. They got us good because, you know, all the Nail Mob, Glow Mob knew that it was supposed to be Naomi getting the championship. So they played us because at the end of that match at the WrestleMania 30, Naomi was the last person in. So that's what got me hyped up. I was like, oh, she finally finna win it. But no, AJ Lee put in the Black Widow and she tapped out. So they played us good. And I said, that was a good match, but they shouldn't play us like that because that hurt my feelings. That hurt my feelings. But we don't care. Cause Naomi gonna snatch her with Bob. Also, I would like for her to go to Raw. There's several people on Raw. I want her to snatch Bayley Bob. Snatch that side ponytail. Kid ponytail out her head. I want her to snatch Charlotte. Real good. Because, to be honest, I love Charlotte. I love Naomi. But however, at the same time, they two are the most athletic women's in the whole WWE women's roster. Period. And I think those two can put up a good match with each other. I know they had matches before. But if they really put them in championship matches and good rivalry, they'll tear the roof off. But yeah, so yeah, Charlotte, Naomi already snatched Sasha Banks ball a few times. To be honest, Nia Jax. I know there'll be a tough fight, but if y'all remember at Survivor Series, Naomi was the really the only one that could put up with Nia Jax. So, yeah. And that's about it. So, thank y'all for everything. We need more questions, so y'all can follow the link below to our websites for the Ask GMs and, you know, ask either TLC some questions or ask me some questions or both. Also, Twitter. You can write on Twitter or the comments below. Just get some questions out there and, you know, just feel the glow. I just made a rhyme, but I don't do crime because I can't pay the time. But anyway, thank y'all. Stay fearless. And we'll see you. What's today? Wednesday? We'll see you next week. Yeah. So, goodbye.
I don't know what I'm feeling right now. So, hope you guys liked this video. And please like, subscribe, and stay tuned for next week. And your woman in our tournament. Bye, guys.